In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to randomly assign different fonts to letters with basic expressions. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel, and let's dive right in. I've already added a comp. First, let's add the text. We choose the type tool from the toolbar and add it. Random fonts, or whatever you want. I use Bio Sans Bold. It is available on Adobe Fonts. Let's set the size to 120. And increase the tracking to 265. Let's choose a font color. Rose maybe. Or whatever you favor. All capitals. We right align the text in the paragraph panel. In the align window, we center align the text layer. Next, we need to add some guides. We use the rulers for that. Make sure your guides are visible. We drag vertical guides into the screen between all letters. So that when we choose more fonts we want to use, we make sure the letters roughly fit in. I am really fast at adding guides. So Bio Sans Bold is the first random font we use. We open the text group and add a source text keyframe at the beginning. Then let's go to 1 second and change the font. I go for Didoni URWD. This is really random. Just make sure there's a recognizable difference in style. We change the color. I think yellow would be nice. Then we roughly adjust the tracking to make sure all the letters are in place. If you click in between letters with the type tool and hold Option for Max, Control if you use a PC, and use the left and right arrow keys, you can adjust the spacing between letters to fine-tune the positions. Awesome. We go to 2 seconds and choose our next font. Fire Sans. And let's use Extra Light. We adjust the tracking again. Increase it. And use the Tab tool to fine-tune the letter positions. At 3 seconds, a different font. I use Heimat Stencil. Heimat is the German word for home or homeland, by the way. That's not why I chose it though. It just looks different to the others. Adjust the tracking. And we forgot to change the color. Let's choose a very bright blue for the third font. And choose a purple for the last one. You can change the styles anytime. Just make sure your time indicator is on the right keyframe. Awesome. This is our font list. And from that list, we randomly pick a font for each letter. Therefore, we need to separate the letters. We click on this animate button here and add an opacity animator. We open the range selector and in advanced, we set units to index. And the end value of the range selector changed. Including the space, we added 12 letters. Each letter has an index number now. Then we set the opacity of the animator to 0. If we set the end value to 1, it hides the first letter. To invert that, we go back into advanced and set the mode to subtract. Instead of adjusting the start and end value by hand for each letter, for the second letter, the start and end values would need to be 1 and 2. We use the index expression. We add expressions to the start and end value. For the start value, we add index minus 1. Index refers to the index value of a layer. 1 minus 1 is 0. For the end value, we add index. The value is 1. Like the index number of the layer. We duplicate the layer and each new layer reveals the next letter. Awesome. Now we want to animate these letters. Let's add a second animator. We select the text layer and add a scale animator. Then we go into advanced and set based on to index, like before. Then we link the start and end value to the start and end value of the first animator, to make sure the values are the same. We use the pick whip tool and link the start values and the end values. The range is the same now. Then we add an expression to the scale value. Let's make more space first. We add an expression, then reduce the frame rate, post rest time, and 4 in parentheses, semicolon. We assign a unique seed value, seed random, and index in parentheses. The seed value is the index number of the layer, semicolon. Then we add a wiggle expression, wiggle, and 3,15 in parentheses. 3 times per second, the value animates max 15 in both directions from the start value. If you want to use expressions and don't know where to start, you should check out my free expression sheet. We select the animator 2 group and add the rotation property. Then we copy the expression we just wrote, we add an expression and paste it to the rotation property. Let's maybe reduce this value to 10. And to make sure the animation comes out of the center of the letters, we go into more options and set the Y value of the grouping alignment to around -40%. Simple expressions can be extremely helpful. Including expressions into your workflow makes you so much faster. To get started, check out my free expression sheet. It covers the most important expressions and explains how to apply them. And you should check out my course to learn how to create complex animations with expressions in After Effects. It starts from zero. In 30 lessons, we go through the basics. Basic expressions, responsive animations, dynamic text animations, and repetitive techniques. Take your animation skills to the next level and learn how to animate with expressions in After Effects. Links are in the description. Next, we need to get the text comp to randomly pick a font out of the list. We add an expression to the source text property. First of all, we reduce the frame rate, post rest time, and 4 in parentheses, semicolon. We assign a seed value, seed random, index in parentheses, semicolon. Then we define a variable. Var s, like seconds, equals math.round. We want whole numbers. And inside the parentheses, random and 0,3 in parentheses, which gets us a random value between 0 and 3. 0, 1, 2, 3, which is where our keyframes are. Finally, we need to jump to these keyframes. Text.sourceText. .getStyleAt. And in parentheses, 0, s. I forgot a semicolon at the end of this statement. GetStyleAt returns the style value of a particular character at a certain time. 0 is the index number of the character. We leave it because we already took care of that. S is the time. So the expression jumps between 0 and 3 seconds and returns the style value. Let's duplicate the layer a few times. Awesome. Let's add more details to the letters. We add a new solid and name it Luma Matte. Color doesn't matter. We move it below the text layer. And add the turbulent noise effect. Let's use the effects and presets window. We double click on it to add it. You adjust some settings, contrast 395, brightness 30, complexity 2. We animate the evolution with an expression. Reduce the frame rate, post-rest time 4 in parentheses, semicolon, then time asterisk 1000. We use it as Luma track mat for the text layer. We switch to the track mat column and link the text layer to the solid. Turn it into a Luma mat. The black parts are transparent. Finally, we add an adjustment layer. Name it Blur. But first, we add a glow effect. Double-click on it to add it. Let's increase the glow radius to around 70. Then we add Gaussian Blur. Blurriness around 25. We use the Luma matte layer as inverted Luma track matte for the adjustment layer. If you wonder why suddenly the second letter is visible instead of the first one, the index number of the layer changed. So we need to go back into the text layer and change the index values for the start and end point. Index minus 2 and index minus 1. And finally, let's duplicate the text layer until all letters are visible. To get to know more about expressions, check out the expression sheet and my course. There are a lot of resources on my website, so you should check out that as well. One last tip, if you change the text, you need to change it for all the style keyframes. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, everyone.